lived in my house and looked a lot like my mother. There was this kid I knew back then, and I was sure that he would be the greatest star I'd ever known. I'd watch him walk into a room, and he was never out of place. He knew the answer to every question, the square and cube of every pride, a name to go with every face, like he was king upon a throne. Yeah, we had nothing in common, nothing in common. My mother was convinced that I failed English out of spite. We had nothing in common, nothing in common. 30-some years later, I'm still tortured and amazed by how David always got the answers right. Lots of friends and was the pride of the family. He punched my head and called me names and made me feel like a dink, and I would hide from him all day. But if I couldn't find a friend, which happened more than I'd have liked, I'd go where he was and sulk around him. He'd say, "You don't know how to throw, and please don't sing your stupid songs," and then he tossed the ball my way. Yeah, we had nothing in common, nothing in common. I thought he was a jerk, and God knows what he thought I'd be. But we had nothing in common, no, nothing in common. But 20-some years later, I'm still grateful and surprised by the little gifts that David gave to me. I knew this guy before I wed. He had a vision in his head of how his life would play out and his dreams would come through. But he was stumbled, he was stalled, and every year after he called, I think, man, there goes the loneliness. God, I ever knew. And people think I'm failing. They never understand. You see, the temporary setbacks, yes, they're part of what I planned. Yes, David had his vision. Made a vow, he took her hand, and they lived happily ever.